Today I'm going to try using a blue underpainting to paint a portrait.
Hi, I'm Sara, and I make art.
I'm putting the blue on over my grisaille. As my guide for this, I'm using Leo Stevens's copy of La Fornarina by Raphael. And that's why I'm putting the blue around the contours of the face. And of course I have a little bit of orange mixed with this blue, so it's more natural looking. According to Mr. Stevens, Raphael actually used a green underpainting for La Fornarina. Using a blue underpainting for a portrait may have been a technique that some old masters used, but it wasn't the only technique they used. By the way, I chose this model because she reminded me of someone who might have been in a Renaissance painting. For her skin, I'm mixing my trusty raw sienna with some zinc white, and because I want it to be rosy, a little bit of red. But I'm also mixing some green into that red so it won't be so bright and obnoxious. Adding this red into the mixture right from the beginning turned out to be a mistake, and I'll explain why when we get to that part. I'm going to be spraying some water in it because this is going to be a glaze, so it has to be thin. I'm applying this color all over the face now, both where I have the blue and where I don't have the blue. And I've thinned the paint down enough that when I put it over the parts that do have the blue, that still shows through. And that's important because there wouldn't have been any point in putting this blue underpainting down if it was going to get covered up with my flesh color layers. Anyway, I decided I wanted the skin to be rosier than it was, so I'm glazing some pink, mixed with a little bit of green though, so it's not too intense, all over the face, including where the blue is, and that's what I realized tripped me up later. See later on that the parts where I have the blue take on a violet tone. But of course, that's the consequence of putting too much red over blue. I ended up mixing the colors together without meaning to. This is a case of not thinking ahead. So why did I make this mistake? I use blue in skin a lot, but I've never put it on before the base color. Put it on as a layer after the base color. More importantly, I think, I didn't have this many layers of skin color either over or under it. So it's just not something that I had to think about. There needed to be more contrast between the left side of her face and the right side, so I went over the right side of her face and her neck with some zinc white. And in my first of many attempts to correct my mistake with the purple, I glazed yellow, the complement of purple, over that area. I was having a lot of problems with this cheek, and I said, screw it, I'm going to start all over, and that means doing the grisaille again. I'm putting layer after layer of the zinc white on, and it just wasn't getting light enough. Anyway, I'm being careful to make the right shape here. I have to follow the contours of her cheek. I can't just slap paint on any old way. I've been painting in multiple strokes, stopping and starting, but I'm making sure that my edges are very smooth before I go on with my second layer, which I'm just going on top with because I've realized I want it to be a bit darker. But what I was saying back there is I want to make sure the edges of my gray are nice and smooth and blended before I go on with my color, which I'm going on top with now. And that's just a combination of zinc white and raw sienna, by making extra sure that's thinned down enough that I'm not covering up this gray underneath, because I want that value to show through. This cheek needs a bluish shadow along the edge, and it needs to be a bit rosier. So I'm glazing some red on top, and I'm going to be blending out my strokes with a mop brush. For her hair, I've glazed over it with a combination of yellow and purple, and I gave her some pale blue highlight. Cool or ash-toned hair often reflects shades of blue or purple. So about that violet tone you see, I ended up doing the same thing that I did with that cheek, which was to completely go over it, completely start over from the beginning, and do the grisaille again. Her eyes have a strong light reflecting on them. To capture that, I'm painting thin lines of titanium white with my liner brush around her pupil. And like the edge of that one cheek, the edges of these white spots have to be very smooth. Otherwise, they really will just look like spots in the eye instead of like the highlights I want them to. To further create that brightness in the eye, I'm glazing some dark blue right next to where I have the white. This provides a contrast between light and dark, which is what gives me that shine. I'm giving her some liner and lashes, and I just really like how this makes her eye stand out all that much more. I painted all the lines and indentations of the lips in the underpainting, and I'm glazing over them with a pinkish red, keeping that layer thin enough so that all those details that I painted show through. I may try this experiment again, but this time I won't mix red right into my flesh color. I'll just glaze it on top of where I want it to be, and that won't be where the blue is. Do I think using a blue underpainting for a portrait is a good strategy? I don't think it guarantees a hyper-realistic result, that's for sure. But a lot of people have blue in their skin because of things like veins and stuff. Putting the blue down first and layering your flesh color over it, rather than vice versa, is a good way to make it look like the blue was underneath the skin, which is how it should look. Here's the finished version of the painting. I once tried to do a portrait by painting the entire face green and then glazing pink over that, thinking that the green and the pink would mix together and I'd get a natural, realistic-looking skin color. I didn't. I make art videos. If you don't want to miss any, click over here to subscribe. And down here you can find my portrait tips playlist, so I can help you bring out your creativity. Thanks for watching!